its entirety is about 8,500 square miles. It's really big. This portion of the river basin is called the Honey Island Swamp. It makes up about 70,000 acres of the river basin in this area. Half of that's owned by the state of Louisiana's Wildlife and Fisheries Department, and they use it as a wildlife management area. So we'll see signs that mark that boundary line of the management area through a good bit of the tour. We'll be running right up the edge of it and kind of darting in and out of it, the management area, through a good bit of the tour. The swamp gets its name from the first European settlers that settled here. They befriended the Native Americans that lived here at the time and spent a lot of time with them in the environment, learning about the different things and places out here. So as a result of that, this many years later, we're still using a lot of the names that were given by those first European settlers. They named this the Honey Island Swamp after the amount of honeybees they found when they first arrived here. Of course, honeybees on a decline everywhere in North America today, and it's no exception in this swamp either. They're on a decline here as well, but they must have had plenty of them for them to name it that when they first arrived. And that's because the swamp really provides a good habitat for bees to make hives in. Some of the trees, like the cypress and the tupelo gums, they form natural hollow spots in them, so it makes perfect beehive habitat. And this is the Pearl River we're on here. The Pearl gets its name from the first European settlers as well. They named this the Pearl after the pearl mussel that they also named. And the pearl mussel has a pearl finish on the inside of the shell, so at the turn of last century, they were still using that to make buttons for high-end clothing. They would shape the shell into a button and they would polish the pearl side of it. Made nice little buttons out of it. Before we had synthetic materials like plastic and nylon that we do that sort of stuff with today, that's the kind of thing they used in the marketplace back then. Trying to get as much of this tour in as I can deeper in the swamp as opposed to riding on this open river. So we're going to run up the river about a half a mile, maybe three quarters of a mile, and we'll turn off to go deeper into the swamp. Y'all ready to go? We'll get a little air moving here. It's a little hot.
How would
you
Thank you.
these other trees in front of us with the flaky bark. That's the black willow. The willow has a medicinal value. Native Americans used to use that as a pain reliever. They would boil the bark of that tree and they made a tea out of it that would relieve their headaches, muscle aches, and fever. Anybody know why that works so well for them? Nobody? It contains the active ingredient for aspirin. That's where aspirin originates from. So they were getting a full dose of aspirin in its most purest form without the additives. That's what that amounts to. The whole tree has that active ingredient. It's just most concentrated in the bark. If you had a headache and chewed the leaves, it would work. It'd be like taking baby aspirin. The lesser dose. Also, a mushroom that grows on those trees that's edible. Probably a nest close by here that they're just leaving from. They're at that age now that they start leaving the nest area and getting pretty much out on that. They're on their own from day one anyway, leaving around the nest area, but they'll hang around close to that nest for the first 2 years or so and then they'll start leaving it.
It looks like the first 2 years, but
that is consistent. Anything small enough for them to get in their mouth? Minnows, insects, frogs, crawfish, stuff like that. Yeah, he's not eating as much as the others.
Good size one coming over here. They come down the river behind us.
Mm-hmm. We have no shortage of alligators. There's plenty of alligators out here.
Wow, that's amazing.
We're overpopulated in the amount of alligators we have.
Right?
Do they have hunting season here?
The month of September is the hunting season here. It's about to open.
Yeah.
How big are, what's the average size of the gator?
Can I get half a
second?
Well, I guess the average would be about 6 to 7 feet. Well, it's full size anyway, an average size of a full size alligator. That's not typically what we see. Typically what we see is 4 and 5 feet.
Look
at that one way over there. They'll live to be 75, 80 years old. I want to go see that pig. Let's see what else
we can find. How big can they grow up to?
The biggest one on record is 15 feet 9 inches. Anybody know the closest relative of the raccoon?
Red panda. Oh, I heard that.
Yeah, he didn't want his coconut.
He said, "It's crusty."
Yeah, the red panda. That's the closest relative.
The red panda, really? Huh? Oh my goodness. Don't go get me
little babies. Oh my goodness. They're fun to play with when they're that size.
Yeah.
I've seen them 20 pounds already.
Yeah, they get pretty big.
Especially if they eat cat food.
Yeah.
We used to have outside cats. And boy, the possums and the coons, they get big.
Yes.
They are fun to play with when they're that size. Wow, they get into everything. They don't listen. They're very stubborn. They don't get their way to retaliate.
They're 2 year olds. I don't care how old they are. They're 2 year olds.
Oh, there's a crocodile over there. Oops.
Alligator.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go see what else we can find.
Oh. more food.
Yeah.
The cypress trees we have in here is a hardwood tree. It's actually a redwood. It's related to the great redwoods and a sequoia family of trees, so they grow to be really old and big like their cousins. Trees were over 3,500 years old and 20 feet in diameter when the Spanish first arrived on this continent. That's what we call virgin cypress, the original growth that was here. Not many left. There's only 8 left of in the whole country.
You got it?
Yeah, got it.
There's no contractor that comes out here to build for these people. It's whatever individual skill they have determines what's being built. So there's a lot of diversity in the building for that reason. Yeah. It's a different lifestyle than most people know. Guess it's not for everybody, huh? That's how they catch blue crab in those large cages right there. Thank you. think they'd like to live out here like this? Yeah? Not to everybody, I don't guess. Pretty peaceful. No crime.
Building a new one over there,